Welcome to a special celebrity edition of Countdown on More 4. Now, it's just like the regular show, really, except that we've got some recognisable faces as contestants. So it's just wonder and hope that they come up with some recognisable words. Now, first of all, let's kick off with actor, comedian, author Charlie Higson. Welcome back, Charlie. Welcome back. Last time you were over in Dictionary Corner, now you're a contender, a contestant. How does it feel?
Well, it was easy being in Dictionary Corner because Susie just gives you all the answers. So I might sneak over there and get some tips.
You might have to have a quiet word under the table. All right. But you're a writer, well-known writer, so probably words are where your talents really lie, or you...
Yes, yes. And I think this is probably the sort of show that writers watch because they sit around all day not working.
Now, you're up against somebody you probably know very well indeed.
It's,
it's Rufus. Everybody knows Rufus Hound. How are you?
I'm fine.
No, you're not. You're a tremendous character. And whenever you come over there, of course, you give us a marvellous poem. No poems now, just brilliant answers.
The time for messing around is over, Nick. Here is where the
truth
climb to Mount Olympus begins.
The truth will out.
Yeah.
Oh, it's amazing. It's great to have you both. And over in the corner, of course, Susie, joined on this occasion by the wonderful Anna Richardson. Welcome, Anna. Of course, is the presenter of Naked Attraction, but we'll be hearing from you a little bit later. But now we turn to Rachel. Rachel, I think you've got something to tell us.
I've got some news. I've got some good news for our contestants. For these celebrity specials, we've decided to change the scoring a little bit. So everyone will score with the words and with the numbers games they get. So if someone gets the numbers game spot on, which I'm expecting from both of you, you get 10 points. But if someone also got one away, two away, you'd still get the 7 points as if the other one didn't do anything. So if one of you were to get a six-letter word and one a seven, assuming they are both words, then one contestant will get 6 points and the other one will still get 7.
It reduces the chance that I'll score 0.
Absolutely.
Exactly.
Only vaguely.
Obliterated. Now then, Charlie, let's start with you. Charlie, it's a letters game. Good luck.
Right, yes. Well, let's start with a consonant.
Thank you, Charlie.
Thank you.
Start with S.
OK. And a vowel?
A.
A. Another consonant.
L.
And another consonant.
N.
And another vowel.
I.
I'll have another consonant.
T.
Thank you. And another vowel.
U.
And another consonant.
M.
And one more vowel.
Good choice. A final O.
Thank you.
And here comes the countdown clock. Charlie?
4.
Thank you. Mr. Hound?
Well, I'll go for 5.
Now then, Charlie?
I'm seeing a lot more now, but I'll go with my 4.
Yes.
Which was slam.
Slam and?
Mounts.
Mounts.
That's a 6, Rufus.
Good.
Are we going to be tough about this? I suppose we've got to be. Oh, Rufus. Oh. Anna, what have you got?
Well, you can, of course, have an 8-letter word, boys. Which
yes.
I'm surprised neither of you got. I'm ashamed of you both. You could, of course, have had tinnamus.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Tinnamus? Timorous I could deal with, but tinnamus? What's that, then, Anna?
Well, I'm going to pretend that I know exactly what that means, but at this point, I defer. To Susie.
Yes, they're tinamous, probably. So it's the plural of a tinamou, which is a ground-dwelling tropical American bird. Looks a bit like a grouse.
I see. Thank you, and well done, Anna.
Thanks, Nick.
All right. Now, so Charlie, by default, is in the lead, and you were so shaken by only getting four, and then Rufus screws it up.
Yeah,
how could
sorry.
You, Rufus? But now, this is serious time now.
Right,
Rachel, what have you got for us?
Well, I'm going to talk you through some countdown numbers tips today. And as Rufus and Charlie have both been on countdown before, Rufus has been on a number of times. I know he's good at the maths game. And they've actually both been on Only Connect Together, and Rufus said that Charlie is Brain of Britain, for giving them a particularly difficult countdown numbers trick today. And when I ask the viewing public what kind of things they want to know, often the four large tricks are the questions that come up the most. And if you Google amazing countdown numbers games, one of the top ones that comes up is actually a clip from 1997 with an Oxford maths PhD called James Martin. And I've actually picked out the numbers that he did at that time, and I'm going to talk you through the amazing countdown numbers game that he did and try and demystify it and actually teach you how to do it on the same kind of, maybe slightly lesser level, because James was impressive. And not saying that you two aren't, but I'm going to walk you through it anyway.
We'll take
we had the four numbers, as we know, the four large numbers, and three and six. And the target that James had to make was 952. Now, I'm sure you've all got it already, but I will talk you through the method that he used. What he said was, wait for this, 100 plus 6... 106, you should still be with me at this stage, times 3 is 318. Then naturally he times it by 75, as you do, for 23,850. He took away the 50 for 23,800, and he divided it all by 25. For 952. You probably got that, didn't you, Nick?
Absolutely.
I mean, that's incredibly impressive, and it's amazing to have done that under pressure and in 30 seconds. But I do just want to write it out a slightly different way so you can see what on earth is going on. If you write it out, 100 plus 6 times 3 times 75, all divided by 25 and take away the 50, what you can see was actually going on here is 106 times 3 times 75 over 25, which is another 3. 106 times 3 times 3 minus 50 over 25, which is 2. So that's all that was actually going on here. And even though that was incredibly impressive, there's one of the basic numbers tricks that you can learn, which I'm going to teach you now, to get you kind of in this ballpark. So one of the tricks you can say is, when you have the four large, you always have the same four large, and you can use 100 times 75 plus or minus the 50, all divided by 25, and that gets you, if you add it, to 302, and if you take it away, to 298, because all you're in effect saying here is 100 times 3 plus or minus 2. And when you say it in the stages that you do, you look incredibly impressive, you confuse everybody at home, and you look like a total genius. So I'm hopefully about to make you two both look like total geniuses with a huge clue here before I pick another four large numbers game for you to solve.
All right.
Excellent. Thank you, Rachel. Now, Rachel, give them a run for their money.
Yes. What I didn't mention to the guys is that you also have two little numbers to play around with as you see fit. James did it the kind of the expert way, but there might be a way for you to solve this problem using that little tip. And as you might have guessed, I'm going for four large and two little ones. And your little ones are 5 and 9, and the large 4, 25, 50, 100 and 75. And the target, 312.
312. Yes, Rufus.
312.
And Charlie?
I got confused trying to do it Rachel's way. I should have done it the simple way.
Yeah.
You can do it the simple way if you've got another way.
Yeah, but I ran out of time to do it the simple way as well.
Shall we stick with Rufus? Rufus.
Yeah, let's just go with
you. You messed up the last letters game. Let's see how you get on today, Rufus.
Well, what I'm now calling the Riley twist...
Yeah?
..is 100...
Yes.
..times 75...
..is 7,500.
Minus 50...
Minus 50 is 7,450.
Divided by 25...
Divided by 25 is 298.
Which, I have to point out, looks really good, but is literally just what Rachel told us to do. And then if you add the 9 and the 5, and you get to 312.
You do indeed. Very well done.
Thank you.
That's excellent. Followed Rachel. Excellent. All right, so 10 points, too. 10 plays, 4. And we then move into a conundrum. Gentlemen, fingers on buzzers. Good luck to you both. We're rolling today's countdown conundrum. Charlie.
Is it shadowing?
Let's see whether you're right. Shadowing. Look at that. 4 points ahead, too. 14 plays, 10, as we go into our first teaser, which is celeb ham. And the clue, it's white and creamy, according to my sources. It's white and creamy, according to my sources. I left with the clue, it's white and creamy, according to my sources. And the answer to that, Susie Dent, bechamel?
Bechamel, yes. Rich white sauce made with milk, infused with herbs and named after the Marquis Louis de Bechamel, who was steward to Louis XIV.
Well, well. Yep. Thank you. White and creamy indeed. So, 14 plays, 10. Charlie in the lead. We turn to Charlie. Charlie, catchphrases you've coined. And a white van passes and the window's wound down and somebody shouts the catchphrase at you. Which one gets the greatest sort of usage, do you think?
Well, none of mine.
All right.
The one that's still used most is suit you, sir. The tabloids still use that. Scorcho's another great one. The weather people still use that one a lot. Mm. I suppose of mine, the one that people find are useful is a Swiss Tony character of comparing anything you choose to making love to a beautiful woman. Mm-hmm. I won't start now because I could actually end up saying something too filthy for the show, but... but, yes, a lot of people do that.
Thank you very much indeed. Charlie, Rufus, you're back on now and you're just a tiny, weeny, tiny bit behind. Ah, there we go. It's your letters game, Rufus.
All right. I've actually had dreams where I'm in this position.
And so you're here today.
She's got a...
Dreams come true.
With this. I will start with a consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Rufus. S.
Consonant.
N.
Consonant.
C.
Consonant.
M.
Ooh, vowel, please.
A.
Vowel, please.
E.
Vowel, please.
I.
Vowel, please.
O.
And consonant.
And the last one, L.
Stand by. Yes, Rufus.
Eight.
An eight? Why are you all grimacing? Well, we'll come to that in a minute.
It's a bit of a push.
Charlie?
Only six.
And you're six, Tony?
Lances.
Lances now. Rufus.
I think I've really made this word up. I thought if you had a melanoma, would that be melanoic?
It would be possibly, there's melanotic, which is excess melanin. There's melanoid, but not melanoic.
The short answer
is
almost.
No.
Almost.
What did the corner conjure up from that little lot?
Well, I managed to get another six, which was lesion.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But actually, you could have had an eight, a really simple word.
Yes.
Everybody's favourite pudding.
Yes.
Semolina.
Semolina.
There it was.
Well done, Anna. So, 20 plays 10. Well done, Charlie.
I'm lucky that Rufus is going for gold. He's aiming high.
And
missing.
And missing. Charlie, it's your letters game now.
Right.
Off we go.
A consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Charlie. F.
OK. And another consonant.
B.
Blimey. I better take another consonant.
S.
And a vowel, please.
E.
And another vowel.
U.
Oh, gosh. Another consonant.
D.
Another vowel.
I.
Another consonant, please.
P.
And another vowel.
And the last one, A.
Thank you.
Stand by. Yes, Charlie.
Just another six, I'm afraid.
Rufus. Rufus.
Yeah, six.
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 Six. Charlie.
Abused.
No, Rufus.
Bipeds.
Mm-hmm. Both excellent. Both good sixes.
Now, what's the corner got?
Well, we did have abused. We did also have bipeds, but we also came up with busied.
Busied herself.
Yes, absolutely.
Thank you. Still 10 points in it, 26 plays 16. Now, Rufus, you're on home ground now. It's a numbers game.
Let's have four large and two
you're
small.
You're going for it. It worked for you well last time.
Yeah.
Four large and two small, and you found confidence.
I wouldn't say that. I just thought it would be rude not to.
You're going bold. Thanks, Rufus. We have three and eight, and the large one's 50, 75, 125. And let's have a look. The target, 243.
243. Rufus?
I can do it. I know I can do it, but I think all I've got is 250.
250? Charlie?
I will concede. Again, I can see it's there, but I will concede it on that one.
Yeah. Withdrawing?
Yes.
Now, Rufus?
Yes. Well, 8 minus 3 times 50 is 250.
8 minus 3 is 5 times 50 is 200. And 50, and you get 5 points for that.
Shall we just pause and allow Rachel to show us? Rachel, 243?
Well, I didn't see any tricky ways to do it, but you could have said 75 plus 8 is 83. 50 divided by 25 is 2. Take that away from the 83 for 81 and times it by 3, and you get 243.
Isn't that nice? Thank you. on. So, only 5 points in it. 26 plays 21. Charlie just ahead as we turn to the dictionary corner, and we turn very particularly towards Anna Richardson. Anna, what have you got for us by way of a little story?
Well, I was going to tell you about how I've come to be in Dictionary Corner, which is, I'm as surprised as you are, because normally I record Naked Attraction in this studio, so, Nick, I'm rather hoping that we're actually, you're naked from the waist down, so I've been told. But I've always been very, very interested in words and the use of language from a very, very young age. I mean, I'm no Susie, but I was going to be, an English teacher. And I was never actually going to be working in television and be a presenter. I come from a family of teachers, and it seemed very natural that I'd be an English teacher. I studied English here in Manchester. There was just one problem, because I got my degree, fantastic. I got accepted onto a postgraduate to do my teaching course, to be an English teacher. Just one problem, which is relevant to this show, I didn't have my maths GCSE. So even though I was in my 20s, the one thing that eluded me was my maths, and I sat that exam 7 times, and to this day, I don't have it, and I was thrown off my PGCE course. Mm. So, education's loss is sort of television's gain. So here I am today, and the reason that I managed to make it into television is because I turned my love of language and my love of words.
Yeah.
And I took that experience and I did a postgraduate in journalism instead.
So, and yeah. You didn't need the maths for that?
So far, so good. I don't need it, and I haven't needed it. But again, I've really tried to use language and words as a way of, through storytelling and journalism, of effecting change.
So sometimes a big disappointment early on can spur you into greater efforts and actually make life much more interesting than perhaps it would have been.
I do think that's a really good point, that you have to take disappointment and you have to, like with words, just reframe them, find a different meaning to what it is you needed and wanted to do, and you can still be fantastically satisfied.
I think that's good advice. Thank you, Anna. So, 26 plays 21, Charlie in the lead, much to Rufus's fury. I can see him fuming there as we turn to our next teaser, which is Nice Dime and the Clue. These balls are sometimes said to be hard to swallow. These balls are sometimes said to be hard to swallow. Back, I left with the clue. These balls are sometimes said to be hard to swallow. Thinks, why? Medicine balls. Medicine is the answer to that. 26 plays 21, and we turn to Rufus.
Yes.
What a career you've had. It's been amazing.
That's very kind of you. It doesn't feel that way to me.
You've been up in Stratford doing amazing things. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, it's very odd if you work mainly as a stand-up comedian, to one day get a phone call from the RSC. Mm. And if you're as white and middle class as I am, it basically feels like God's ringing. So I got to do Don Quixote a few years ago, and then we did that in the West End. Mm. And at the end of that job, they were doing some restoration comedy, and I was asked, would you want to join that? And in between that, I'd done some workshops for them for Boy in the Dress, the musical adaptation of the David Walliams book. So actually, this last 12 months, I've worked solidly for the RSC, which has basically made all of my mum's dreams come true.
Brilliant. And you were singing too. Were you trained as a young man?
Chorister.
Were you?
Yeah.
All right.
And always rated myself, was always sort of going for it. And so the biggest gig of the year is always singing once in Royal David City as you process down for the Christmas Carol concert.
Okay.
Which I did, to the tune of Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Unlike everybody else.
Yeah, quite.
Brilliant stuff.
Just
thank
you. On
you.
Your own.
Now, Rufus, you've got to pay attention now.
Yes, tell me.
Not
about
long
it.
To go, we're in the home straight. Charlie, it's your letters game.
We'll start with a consonant, please.
Thank you, Charlie. L.
And another one. Thank you.
K.
I better take another one.
H.
H.
Yep.
Can you give me a good one next, please?
I'll try.
Another consonant, please.
How's an R for you?
All right, we better have some vowels then.
Give me
and two vowels, please.
And U.
And another vowel, please.
E.
And a consonant.
S.
Oh.
Everyone loves an S.
And another consonant.
And the last one, C.
And the clock starts now. Charlie?
Best I could do was six.
A six for Charlie. Rufus?
Seven.
Mm-hmm. Charlie?
Closer.
And Rufus?
It's my game. Shocker.
And over in the corner, Anna and Susie.
Well, that's very good, boys, I have to say, but you could have had an eight, and I think this could appeal to both of you. You could have had Suckhole.
Is one who suckholes not a suckholer? Could we, was there not a name there?
No. Oh. And actually, it may surprise you, Suckhole is a whirlpool, or in Canada and Australia, it's a sycophant. So not possibly what you were thinking. Well, I suppose maybe. If you were a sycophant, then maybe.
32 to 28. Nothing in it, really. Rufus, your letters game.
Is there... Can I just ask? I've always wanted to know this on Countdown.
Uh-huh.
Is there a reason people don't just say four consonants and four vowels?
Yeah, we kick them out.
Oh, is that right?
We beat them up. We send someone in.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Rufus.
D.
And another.
T.
And another.
J.
And a better.
Fussy. F.
And a vowel.
I.
And another.
A.
And another, please.
U.
And another.
E.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final S.
Stand by. Rufus.
Hang on. Seven.
Seven. Brave stuff. Charlie.
Sounded a little to me like he was just adding letters after time was up.
I'd got it. I just hadn't written it down or counted the letters. I promise.
Charlie.
I only say that because I only got a six.
And Charlie's six is?
Jesuit.
Capital J. Mm.
Yeah, capital J.
No, it was...
Sorry. No can do. Rufus, what was yours?
Fausted.
Fausted.
Oh.
Isn't it fausted? Like, if I force you to do something, I've fausted something upon you.
Foist.
Oh, foisted.
No!
I've got another four-letter word beginning with F if you need it. I haven't got the letters, but I've got the will.
Bad
luck.
Sorry. You have to disallow both, Nick.
But you could have had a seven-letter word.
Mm.
A feudist. A feudist.
Somebody loves a little feud.
Yes.
A feudist.
Somebody who takes part in a duel.
Yeah. Thank you. 32-28. Stand still. And it's Charlie's numbers game.
Could I have two of the larger ones, please?
You can indeed.
And however many.
And four of my small numbers.
Yes.
Four of my lovely smalls. Thank you, Charlie.
How many there were?
The other way around. Two large, four small. And the four smalls this time are three, four, two, and eight. And the large one's 125. And your target, 251.
251. Charlie?
I've got 251.
251 for Charlie and Rufus.
Yes, same.
Same? Yeah. Now, Charlie?
100 plus 25.
100 plus 25, 125.
Times 2.
Times 2 for 250.
And 4 minus 3
gives you your 1. And that's 10 points for Charlie.
And Rufus? Same way.
Exactly the same way.
Why not? Why not?
All he's written on here is, I owe you £5.
Always study these little notes that get pushed across. Thank you. 42, please. 38. Susie, it's your wonderful Origins of Words slot.
Well, I'm hoping I'm going to be able to pay homage to everybody today because the word that I'm talking about is titchy, which happens to be one of Anna's favourite words. And it takes us both to the theatre for Rufus and also to a kind of catchphrase or stage name, which might involve Charlie. So titch or titchy, something small, nicknames from the start, and because you'll often find people in school called titch unkindly. But the story of both of those words takes us back to one of the most notorious cases, court cases of Victorian times. And a person called Roger Titchborne, who was the son of a really wealthy Hampshire family, but vanished in 1854. All traces of him and his belongings were completely lost. And one theory was that the ship he was sailing on was lost at sea. It sank, and he sank with it. But when she got word that her son had disappeared, Lady Titchborne completely refused to believe that her son had gone, and she placed ads all around the world appealing for him to get in touch and come home. And she accepted a claim from an Australian butcher from a wonderful sounding place called Wagga Wagga. And he said that he was her son, he was the true heir to the baronetcy and also the associated estate because it was worth a lot. Even though, over time, he'd become a lot shorter and a lot fatter, it has to be said, and lost his extremely strong French accent. But anyway, several other members of the family refused to accept him. They just thought, this is ludicrous. But she was determined that he was her son come back. And after she died, it was after she died that it all happened, the family said, no way are we having this, so they took him to court. And this court case was phenomenal. It lasted over 101 days and it absolutely had the British public enthralled. His case totally unravelled and the butcher was tried for perjury. He was released from prison finally in about 1884. He did a nationwide tour of music halls and circuses, went to the US, tried his best to kind of make money out of this case, but sadly died in poverty a few years later. Such was his notoriety and such was the importance of the case for the public that pictures of him were in every single newspaper. And music halls of the time thought, we're going to trade on this and we will call ourselves the Young Titchborne. If they looked even vaguely like him, they sort of they took on this nickname. And one in particular was called Harry Ralph. It was his heyday coincided with Titchborne being sentenced to 2 7-year spells in prison. He was double jointed acrobat. He was pretty amazing. He would tiptoe on shoes that were 28 inches long, and he was only 4'6". And he became as famous for his sort of short stature as for his sort of remarkable feats, if you like, on the stage. He called himself Little Titch because he looked a little bit like the Titchborne claimant. And it was that stage name that actually propelled Titch, not because of his amazing feats, and it's simply because he was quite tiny, that propelled Titch and Titchy into the language for somebody perhaps a little bit shorter than usual. But it all goes back to Sir Roger Titchborne, a person whose fate has never been quite determined.
Fantastic. Little Titch. Rings a bell, actually, Little Titch. This would have been in late 1800s?
Yes, yeah, so sort of or early 20th century as yeah. Well, so he was still on stage for quite some time.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Thanks, Susie. So 42 to 38, Charlie still in the lead, only by 4 points as we turn to our next teaser, which is Ended Acts. And the clue, self-indulgent people and the old record label was Susie's. Self-indulgent people, and the old record label was Susie's. Welcome back. I left you with a clue. Self-indulgent people and the old record label was Susie's. And the answer to that is decadence. Decadence. 42-38. Rufus, letters game for you.
I'm going to start with a vowel, please.
Thank you, Rufus. O.
And another?
E.
And another, please.
I.
And another, please.
E.
Oh,
like that.
Oh, this is exciting, isn't it? Anything could happen now. Consonant, please.
H.
And another.
C.
And another.
S.
And another.
G.
And one more, please.
And the last one. R.
Stand by. What do you make of that, Rufus?
I'm going to stick with the seven.
What about Charlie?
That's a wise move, because I'm only risking a six.
Rufus?
Cheerio.
Cheerio and Charlie.
Cheers.
And cheers. Mm. Could you get beyond the seven, Anna?
Well, do you know, it's such a shame, Rufus, that you didn't go with your gut instinct, because we think that you could have eight with Cheerios.
We think. It's debatable, yeah. Because you can have a couple of hellos, a couple of goodbyes. It says it's an exclamation rather than a noun. But I think on balance, I would have said yes. Mm. Yes, but luckily I didn't have to make that decision, but Cheerios.
Not critical, though, but no. Cheerios.
Yes.
48-45. Hmm. Close run thing. Charlie, it's your letters game.
Let's go for a nine. Could I have a consonant, please?
Double points, you know. W.
And another one, please.
N.
And another one.
D.
OK, like indeed.
Yeah.
I'll have another consonant, then.
M.
And a vowel, please.
O.
Another vowel.
A.
And another vowel.
I.
Another vowel.
E.
And a consonant, please.
And the last one, D.
And here's the countdown clock. What do you think, Charlie?
I still can't get past six. I'm sure there's a longer one there, though.
How did Rufus get on? Rufus?
Yeah, I only got a six.
You're cross with yourself?
There's just a bunch of things that, yeah, wasn't quite there, so six.
Charlie?
Domain.
Mm-hmm. And Rufus?
Winded. Mm-hmm.
Can you get beyond six?
You can. So, Charlie, you had domain. You could have turned it into a little bit of French and had domain. So you could have had seven.
With an E on the
with
end.
With an E on the end.
I toyed with the idea.
I can see why you wouldn't have wanted to have gone there. You could also have had diamond.
Diamond. There we are. 54 plays, 51. It's Rufus's letters game. Rufus.
A consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Rufus. V.
And a vowel, please.
O.
And a consonant, please.
T.
And a vowel, please.
E.
And a consonant, please.
Very musical. Ah! Oh.
And a vowel, please.
You might get a five here. A.
And a consonant, please.
D.
And a vowel, please.
I.
And a consonant, please.
And the last one. T.
Stand by. Rufus, what do you think?
Seven.
A seven for Rufus Jolly?
Would you be amazed if I said six?
And your six is...
Rotted.
Rufus.
If someone was Dotty and the next person next to them was more Dotty, would that person be Dottier?
They would. Mm. Yes, well, very well done.
Mm. Over in the corner there, Anna and Susie.
There are two eights, aren't there?
There are.
Yeah. There are two eights. You could have had deviator, which both of you are.
Yes, you could have had rotative, all to do with engines, and, yeah, it's all to do with engineering, essentially.
So, rotative. Yeah.
So, 1658, as we turn to Rachel. Rachel, time for numbers, I think.
Well, I think I should give these contestants one more chance to look like geniuses. So I'm going to see if they were paying attention. If we get a lucky target, and I'm going to go with four large and two little, just for a little bit of fun.
All right.
And this final numbers game is two and three, and the large ones, 25, 50, 75 and 100. Fingers crossed for a nice target. 203.
Oh. 203. Gentlemen, Charlie?
Yes, I got 203.
And Rufus, too?
I was just a few away. No, I was at 203.
Let's get this over with. Charlie?
100 divided by 75 times 50 divided by 25... No, it's... 2 times 100...
200.
Plus 3.
Plus 3. 203.
Well, Rufus. Here we go.
Yes, I did it the same way.
Shall I show you another way?
Yes,
please. It's kind of like the mirror image of the 302. We've got 203. Right. What you could have said was 100 times 50 is 5,000. Take a... sorry, add 75. For 5,075 and divided it all by 25 and you would have also got 203.
Thanks, Rachel. But what we have got here, actually, is a 70 to 68 situation. Final round, it's the conundrum round. Gentlemen,
okay.
Fingers on buzzers. You ready? We're rolling today's countdown conundrum. Rufus.
Subwoofer. Oh.
Let's see whether you're right.
Oh!
Yes! Rufus. You snatched a win.
I absolutely
on the conundrum.
Can't believe that. I never get the conundrums.
Look,
that's
that.
Incredible. I was out on Friday night with my wife's cousin, and she said, I'm not funny, but I've written a joke. What do you call a dog underwater? A subwoofer.
And there you are.
And we all laughed. staff to be polite, and here I am. So if you're watching, Stacey, wherever, thank you so much.
Well done, Rufus, that's brilliant. You win.
Yes.
78 to Charlie's 70, and Charlie was leading manfully right through, and then in comes the subwoofer.
Yeah.
How could you? I'm so sorry, Charlie. You played like a trooper. You really did. Now, Anna, it's great to have you in Dictionary Corner. Thank you so much. See you both next time. And, of course, Rachel too.
And I'd just like to congratulate Rufus on his dreams coming true today, because I know he's a proper Countdown fan. He's been here before and he's probably nicked a teapot, but now he's legitimately won one as well.
Indeed. And he's got his kryptonite.
He does indeed.
Priceless. See you next time.
See you then.
So that's all for this special Celebrity Countdown. Join us again next time. You be sure of it.
She's definitely seen him before, but he has no idea where. A whole load of new first dates about to happen over on Channel 4 next. And here on More 4, an extraordinary love story comes out during 24 Hours in A&E. That's next.